Hi everyone, welcome back to the Scriptcase Macros course. My name is Nate Carpenter and today we're looking at the button macros. So these are several macros that will allow us to determine when a button is clicked or allow us to show or hide a button. So let's get started and look at what these are. So the first one is actually these five here. So the copy button, delete, insert, new, and update. And all of these macros allow us to determine when a button is clicked. So they're going to return true when the corresponding button is clicked. And we'll look at how to use them in some different events. Then our next macro allows us to show or hide a button. So this is the SC button display. So choose whether or not to display a button. So let's go ahead and look at some of the documentation for some of these. They're all kind of the same with the exception of the button ones and the display ones here. So here's the documentation for button copy here. And this is the same for delete, insert, update, or new. So it's just, you just put it right there and then it's going to return true. So you can put it in an if statement like that. And then if you scroll down here is the SC button disable. So you just pass through the button name and disable it. So let's go ahead and get started with this delete one here so I can show you how to use that. So let's go over and copy this, take this over to Scriptcase. We're going to put this in a form on the onValidate event. So I've got a form here. Let me go ahead and run this so you can see what it looks like. Okay, so here it is, basic form. Let's start here with the delete button here. So we've got all these buttons. Let's start with the delete button. So let's go back over the script case here and go to events here and then on validate right here. There's our on validate event. So we can put that code over there in the on validate event. So let me go there and copy it. So SC button delete, and let me change. Actually, this message is good. So it's an error message. So it's going to stop the processing here and tell them that they can't delete the record. So I'm going to load this form again after I run it. Go ahead and click delete. It's going to pop up a confirmation message, which is not ours. So this is not the message we put in. Click OK. It's going to come back around here. And it's going to say unable to delete this record. It's got the error icon and the record is still there. It was not deleted. So now let's go over and do the same with copy. So that's how we use the SC button delete. Now let's do SC button copy. So we copy that. That needs to be on the on script init or the on load for the form. So let's go ahead and put it on the on load here. And I'm going to go ahead and copy that code in. Okay, so there it is. And we need to make sure we do the correct messaging macro here. So SC alert. And it's just saying that the record is copied successfully. So now we can go ahead and click that copy button and it'll pop up our message. So let's go ahead and run this application here. Wait for the load here. And let me go to it here. There we go. So it's all loaded. Let's go ahead and hit the copy button here. Let's go ahead and hit the copy button here. And there we go. There's our message that we popped up, record copied successfully. So now let's do the same for some of the other buttons here. So we're going to copy this system and this is going to be on the update button. So if I go out of this add mode here, so click cancel, wait for the form to come back around here. And this is going to be on this update function. So it's going to be on the save button when that button is clicked. So that's the update button. So let me go ahead and copy this system here. And I just need to change the button macro here to update, SC button update, SCBTN update here, and change our message to record updated successfully, like so. So now when you click the updated button, it'll pop up this message. So let's go ahead and run this. Wait for it to load here, and then go ahead and hit save on this, and it'll pop up our message. There it is, record updated successfully, just like we put in there. So now let's do the add new. So this is a new button. So to do this, we need to just copy the system again and then just change out the button macro here from update to new, like so. And then change our message to add button clicked. So this is not doing any database logic here. It's just changing to the add mode of the form. So we're just getting that the button was clicked. So click add new here. It's going to come around and load the form, and then there's our add button clicked message. So then our last button here is this add button. So this is the insert button. And let's go ahead and copy this. And this is going to be like the delete button. It's going to be in the on validate event, not in the on load event. Okay, so it's copied in there. And we're going to go ahead and change this messaging out here. And we're going to go ahead and stop the processing like we did on delete. So we're going to say the new record cannot be created. And then we're going to change our alert macro here to the error message like we did on the delete. So that's going to stop the processing because it's an error message. And now we just need to make sure to change out the button macro to SC button insert and then go ahead and run this. So this is our last button here. Let me go ahead and wait for this load here, then click add new. And that's going to pop up our first add button clicked message. And then we can go ahead and enter in some values for this field. Let me go ahead and make sure I enter it in correctly. So first name, John, last name, Smith. Email, I'll go ahead and put my email, anycarpenter@gmail.com, active one, and then click add. Wait for it to come around here. And there we go. So new record cannot be created, so that record was not added. So now our last macro is the SE button display macro, which allows us to show or hide a button. So let me find it here, SE button display. So we pass in the button name and then on or off, depending on what we need to do with the button. So here's an example of all the buttons that are by default part of a grid. So it's broken up by the different applications. So those are all those different buttons with the names and what they do. So if you need to find which button you want to hide or show, there's the name for it, the official Scriptcase name. Here's the one for the form. We're going to be doing this on a form control application. And then here's an example of how to do it here. So let me copy this one. And this one is actually ready to go as is. So this is going to be the new button. So that's going to be that add new button. And we're going to go ahead and we're going to put it on a form application. And it can go in any of these events here. So let's go over and put it on our onload event here. Put it right below all of our other code. And so this is going to show the add new button that showed on the update mode of the form. So let's go ahead and run this. Wait for it to load here. And there we go. So our add new button is gone. So they can only update the record here or copy the record. So that's how you use the button macros in Scriptcase to modify what happens when a button is clicked and whether or not buttons are displayed.